This is Kerry Siders with the Texas A&M AgriLife Extension Service in Hockley, Cochrane, and Lamb counties. Today I'd like to review the process of determining maturity of a cotton plant and setting it up for harvest, and particularly applying harvest aids. And we do that by a couple different methods. We can estimate the percent open cotton. We can use the knife method, where we actually slice open the boll and determine maturity of the seed coat. But really the best, in my estimation, and one that's been around for about 20 years, was established by Dr. James Supak and Dr. Kirby and even Cater Hake back in the 80s, is counting the number of nodes above cracked boll. Somewhat similar to the method we talked about a few months ago of looking at nodes above white flower, this is a process where we actually count first position nodes above the uppermost cracked boll. And that really gives us an idea of how mature those bolls are above that cracked boll. And in fact, there's a nice chart that shows the maturity, that when we have five or fewer nodes above cracked boll, those bolls above it should all be mature. In fact, if you were to cut that fourth and fifth boll, in fact, it would be very difficult to slice through those bolls. But if you could, you would see a very nice seed coat, that brown line forming around the seed and very little jelly. So as we look at a cotton plant here that obviously still needs a little more time, and the first thing we notice is that it does have two open bolls at the bottom. They are fully open. And as we move up to the next position, this is our uppermost fully open boll. We want to check the boll directly above that. Again, first position. And we want to squeeze on that boll and see if it will pop. This one does. So this is actually our uppermost cracked boll. So what we do is begin to count directly above that. As I spin this so that you can see it, because these nodes do spiral up the plant, so I'll have to spin it. This is number one node, two, three, four. This one's missing, but we'll go ahead and count it. Five, six, seven. We have seven nodes above the uppermost cracked boll. At seven nodes above cracked boll, we still need at least another 10 to possibly even 14 days, depending on weather. The process still takes a certain amount of heat units to progress up the plant. And that's another important point that for some of the beginners of cotton 101, understand that everything happens from the bottom and progresses up the plant. So bowls open, they start at the bottom and move up the plant. That's a really important first step. So this plant has seven nodes above cracked boll. It's still too green. If I were to take a knife, in fact, let's just try that right now, and slice through this uppermost boll, it should cut almost like butter. Now, it's a little tough. The fiber's forming pretty good. But if we look at the seed, and it may be a little difficult to see, it still has some jelly, and there's really not much in the way of a seed coat being formed yet. So we still need to give this plant some time. So as we look at a little more mature plant, we notice, again, right off the bat, we have more open bowls, completely open. In fact, I would estimate this plant to be near 40 to almost 50% open. But if we start down here at the bottom, first position, we've got one, two, three, four open bowls. That's good. Let's go the one directly above it and see if we can crack it with our forefinger and thumb again. And we can. Now, if you cannot pop that bowl open, then you can move back down to that open bowl and you start there counting your nodes above cracked boll. So anyway, we were able to crack this. We'll start here and we'll count the nodes above it. As I spin the plant, we've got one, two, three, Four is missing, but and then we have five. Five nodes above cracked bowl. In principle, this plant is mature enough that we could apply both a defoliant and a bowl opener, and it would go through the process and be ready to be set up for stripping, picking within the next 10 to 14 days. Now, the thing that we all know is that fields are rarely as uniform as just this one plant. There's some variability. We get edge effects. There may be more water available. There may be water standing in portions of the field. So we have to take at least 10 plants in four different areas. So one point that I want to further explain on this nodes above cracked bowl is so that you, when you find that uppermost cracked bowl, again, first position, you count those nodes whether they have a bowl or not, and you count all the way up to the point that you feel like that is my last harvestable bowl. Okay, that is the bowl that has achieved sufficient size, will contribute to both yield and quality. Anything above that, that really will deter from quality, and it's too small really to mature out. Here we are filming this on September 22nd. The odds of having sufficient amount of heat units to mature out a bowl that's still thumb size or smaller, it just won't work that way. So really we have to stop counting those nodes when we reach that bowl that is of sufficient size. In fact, on September 22nd, I would like to see that bowl being a good size speckled bowl. And in fact, that's when you could take that knife, try to slice through it. If you can't slice through it, you know it's probably sufficiently mature. But also, if you look at that seed, slice that seed open, you should see a very dark seed coat around it. So we've hit that five nodes above cracked bowl. That's the magic point at which we can start applying harvest aids, particularly defoliants and bowl openers. If we've let that cotton mature out sufficiently long enough, of course, it will naturally continue to open on its own. If at some point we reach fewer than two nodes above cracked bowl, it may become unnecessary to actually expend money on a bowl opener, because over the course of a few days, if you were just to put a defoliant on a crop that only has two or fewer nodes above cracked bowl, it will naturally open on its own by the time you're ready to strip that. And in fact, here is a plant that exhibits that very thing. In fact, if we look at the near percent of open bowls, it's probably in the 80 to 85%. And that's why we oftentimes don't like to use the method of percent open bowls. Unless you actually count all the bowls, it's really a guess, an educated guess on what the percent is. But this only has two nodes above uppermost cracked bowl. So you could, in theory, not put dollars into a bowl opener. Now, we all know that the price of Ethifon has come down considerably over the last 5 or 6 years. And Ethifon does an amazing thing when we mix it with defoliants. It synergizes and we get really much better results, particularly we're in that 1 quart range of Ethifon. And the other thing, we know that, as I was mentioning earlier, we have portions of the field, particularly that edge effect or areas where water stood during the growing season, that may cause those parts of the field to maybe have a few more nodes above cracked bowl. So Ethifon always kind of levels out that bowl opening process and gets it all on the same page. This is Kerry Siders. Thank you.